Hello Taurus, this is your extended reading. So let's go straight into your reading because it is really beautiful. So we start off with the Nine of Wands, and really different from the traditional meaning of this card. I feel like so the word that came through this card was belonging, right? Because you started with the Ace of Wands in the first part, right? I felt like this connectedness with this one nature being, right? A tree or a pet or a flower or, you know, some creature that is from this natural world. But it's only one. It's like a specific being, right? And here, I feel like after you go all of this process and you realize you are this Empress, I feel like with this Nine of Wands, I feel like you're going to find others that do feel this connectedness with nature as you do, right? So I'm seeing you as this one because, you know, you are also the Queen of Wands, so you hold this nature heart in your being, right? So I feel like others are here to match this connection, but to so the word that's coming through is to enrich these roots. I feel like it's like a process of nurturing, but not, it's like you're being nurtured by the connection with others that I just saw, like a beautiful orb right now. It's so gorgeous. I feel like these elementals, these nature beings are all over your reading today. So yeah, maybe actually right now it's coming through like that. Maybe you're not even meeting other humans that are so connected to nature. Maybe you are, but I feel like maybe you're starting to see these fairies, these elementals, these gnomes, you know, these creatures of the forest, of the garden, in a way that they're more perceivable to your eyes, right? So you're seeing these beings and they're feeling like family. They're feeling like they're nurturing your roots, right? Because if we think of the roots as this, you know, sustaining element, which is crucial, right? I can speak right now. I'm scattered right now, but I hope you understand what I mean, right? These creatures are nurturing you. These nature beings are just feeding you with this life force again, right? And so the two cards that came next are really powerful, the Magician and the Chariot. And so okay, there's two things going on right now. With this Magician card, I just felt like there is enormous, because I feel like you're regaining your life force, right? Your power to live, your zest for living, right? I feel like you're in a whole new level of manifestation, right? This is one thing. But the other thing that I'm seeing with this card today is that maybe you're not seeing the full picture yet, right? Because I feel like you're still being fed by these nature beings, by these creatures of the forest or of the garden. So I feel, because when we think of, you know, the hat of the Magician, where that rabbit comes out of, it's in the opposite side. It's like this, right? But it's turned downwards. So I feel like there's still some, I feel like these nature beings are preparing some sort of surprise to you, some magical surprise for you. And when this Chariot came, when I was shuffling, this one jumped off and onto the ground, right? Onto the floor. and it was upside down. So upside down, it was like this, turned like this. So I only saw it when I turned the cart. So, and I was surprised because I felt like, yeah, I just, with these two cards, I just get this sensation of surprise, something unexpected, but a really good surprise, you know? Something magical, something, yeah, it feels not like like a magic trick that nature is playing on you, but maybe it is, but it feels like something that you'll be so delighted, and it's going to be so forward moving, right? It's going to pull you into this, oh, okay, so the word that's coming through, it's going to pull you in this new perception of nature, right? So because I feel like you already are perceiving nature in a whole new way, right? But I feel like it's going to be like this jump. It's almost like you're seeing magic. You're seeing magic happen in front of your eyes, right? And it's about to be so adorable. It's so sweet, this energy. But it feels a bit mischievous in a way that it's childlike. It's childlike, but it is really enchanting. It's just so, it's mesmerizing, right? I cannot stop thinking about this surprise because I don't know what it is, right? It is a surprise, but I just get this feeling that it's going to be so magical for you, Taurus. So, but yeah, I just wish I could stay here, but the message goes on, and it's the Seven of Swords. So this card brings up all of the swords energy from the first part, but also it connects to this Seven of Cups, right? And I feel like even though you are being fed with new life force, this new zest for life, this new hunger for life, right? Because of this restored connection with these nature beings. But I feel like you're going to be a little bit doubtful, a little bit okay, so not doubting in a way that maybe these magic tricks are just tricks, right? But I feel like you're going to be careful, right, with what you're seeing, because this feels so magical that for human eyes, traditional eyes, maybe they would look like tricks, right? Magic tricks. And I feel like because of all the hurt from this recent past, where you lost this connection with nature, I feel like you're going to be a little bit suspicious, right? Not that you're not believing in this magical surprise that may be approaching you, but I feel like you're going to be a little bit suspicious. Yeah, a little bit like keeping your distance, right? Yeah, the word that's coming through, skeptical. A little bit skeptical. But I think this is going to last just a short amount of time because everything's about to be so magical again after this questioning point. It's just a questioning point, right? Just this, maybe, but it's, you know, this sort of questioning phase. But because of these next three cards, that are just the most loving cards ever. The Two of Cups, the Three of Cups, and the World. Where do I begin with this? So, I'm just overwhelmed with love right now. Because I feel like you're going to be so delighted, so mesmerized, and even suspicious that this could be actually true, that this could be actually happening in front of your eyes. And the way that it's coming true, and maybe this is the surprise that these nature beings are orchestrating, are just preparing for you and nurturing you so that you can be ready to receive this. Is this energy of a beautiful heart-to-heart connection to someone, right? Even though here, as I said before, it could be, you know, other people that are connected to nature, but it could not. It could be just like these nature beings coming to you and showing themselves to you. But I feel like whether you met new people or not, I feel like this surprise that is going to arrive really soon in your life, it is connected to this relationship, to this really loving and romantic. It feels so romantic. It feels, I am reluctant to that word because I am a hopeless romantic, so I try to just you know, not be just taken by it, because it could be just overwhelming, right? But I feel like, so it is romantic, it is sweet, it is loving, and it's not only just it's not only the connection of two hearts, right? Because it's what I'm seeing with these Two of Cups. It's also, it feels with this Three of Cups, it's almost like this meeting of two people really aligned with their own hearts and just, you know, coming together. It's supposed to multiply this love. It's supposed to create some sort of, it is the expansion of the heart, right? Because, you know, two and three, you know, when two become one, and then they create this third thing that is actually the relationship. The relationship itself could be this new creation. But I feel like there is something really, it's so pure, it's so beautiful that is coming out of this meeting of the hearts, right? And with this Whirl card, I feel like it's this is so romantic, but I just heard that song from the Aladdin movie, A Whole New World. Taurus, this is so beautiful. I feel like you're going to be taken on this new adventure, on a carpet ride to this new world with this one, right? And it just, I just saw this image, like you're being woken up by this other person. You're sleeping in your garden so peacefully, resting, right, from all this turmoil, recent experience, and reconnecting and allowing yourself to be nurtured again by nature. And then suddenly this beautiful person comes along and just sweeps you off your feet and takes you on this carpet ride, you know, around the world. It's just, it is magical, right? It may be a little bit over the top. It may, you know, in reality, I feel like some messages are just so exaggerated to make a point, right? It could not play out as I'm saying, but the way that I'm seeing, it is really poetic. It is really romantic. It is really magical, right? And, but it has this purpose of creating something that is full of love. It's just the way it's coming through. It's full of love, right? Because it's the meeting of two hearts that are just so awakened. Two hearts that are really awakened. Two hearts that are really connected, not to the outer nature, but their inner nature. So they are just, they are full of life, full of love. And when they two meet, it's just this expansion of love and this, you know, this creation of this third thing that, I don't know what it is, but it feels so, it's so full of love. It's so full of love. This is so gorgeous. This is so beautiful. This is amazing. Incredible. Gorgeous. So, Taurus, Let's see what the runes want to add to this beautiful carpet ride story. Okay, so the rune that came out was Aquarius. So the only thing that I'm getting here right now, and these messages are always very simple, right? So I feel like you're connecting to this new vibration of the age of Aquarius. As simple as that, right? I feel like, okay, so maybe this creation of this two hearts meeting and creating this third thing that is so beautiful and full of love, I feel like it is completely aligned with this new era, this new age of Aquarius, right? And oh, okay. So remember when I told you about you connecting to one creature here, and then in the second part you're expanding this connectedness, this connection is spreading, and you're reaching farther out into, you know, into the earth and connecting with other beings that are nurturing you with this life force, right? And Aquarius, it's such gregarious, it's such it is the sign of connection and reaching out and making friends and relating to others and being open to meeting new people, right? So I feel like it is this openness of your heart that actually is allowing not only meeting and perceiving these nature beings, but also preparing yourself to receive someone that has this big heart as you do, this connected heart as you do, right? And maybe this is, you know, the opening of this new age, and it's so beautiful, it's so gorgeous. It's just, yeah, even with this world card ending the second part, right, because it is the last card of the major arcana, so it is this completion, right? Actually, it is the completion for this new beginning, for this new age. Okay, oh my god, this message is so earth-based, this new earth, that's what I'm getting right now. This new age of Aquarius and this world card, it's just right now that you're talking to me about this emergence, this birth. Maybe that's what you're birthing. That's what this, you know, connection is bringing about, right? This new earth, because we are in the dawn of this new age. So it is the emergence of this new earth, right? And you have to be able to perceive it in another way, in a way that you're connected to nature in a different level, right? So that's why maybe you had to go through all of that process of, you know, feeling the loss, but also feeling the nutrition, the life-giving force, you know, this tree of life building in yourself, you know, emerging in your own inner being and outwards, right? It's just so gorgeous. I'm just seeing this so clearly. I hope you can see it too, because this is not only magical and, you know, this fiction kind of story, but I feel like this is new life. This is how life is going to look like, at least for you, Taurus. So yeah, I hope it was helpful. I hope it was inspiring to you. Yeah, thank you so much for being here with me. Okay, take care. Bye.